Listening Library presents Ordinary People Change the World.
I am Neil Armstrong.
By Brad Meltzer. Illustrated by Christopher Eliopoulos. Read for you by Marc Thompson and an ensemble cast.
I am Neil Armstrong. I grew up on a farm with no electricity. When I was 8 years old, my goal was to climb this silver maple tree, the biggest one in my backyard. It seemed impossible. The tree was so big, and I was so small. How would I do it? I'd need to be brave. I wasn't a brave kid, though. Back in Ohio, when I was 3 years old, I got scared when we went to see Santa Claus.
Say cheese.
I'd also need to be smart. As a kid, I loved to read. In first grade, I read more than 100 books.
Really?
Yep, more than 100 in 1 year. Finally, I'd need to be patient. During Monopoly games, when my brother would get upset and kick the table, I always stayed calm. Yet to climb that huge tree, the only way to get to the top was this. I had to take that first step. Up we go. Climbing the tree was like a puzzle. I needed to pick the right branches in the right order. I had to engineer, or figure out, a solution. I had to use my brain even more than my body. Plus, I loved the feeling of being so high up. But then, I grabbed a dead branch and...
crack!
I fell. 15 feet. I landed flat on my back.
Should I get Mama?
Yeah.
Luckily, I wasn't hurt. On that day, I did learn not to grab dead branches. But the most important thing I did was get back up again. Success never comes easily. It takes hard work. And when it came to hard work, I was really good at that. At 10 years old, I mowed grass at a cemetery for 10 cents an hour. Then I worked at a bakery. I was so small, I could fit into the mixing vats to clean them. Those jobs helped pay for the one thing I loved more than anything else. Airplanes. My mom bought me my first toy plane when I was 2 or 3 years old. After that, I was always zooming around the house and through the neighborhood.
Vroom!
That kid really likes planes, doesn't he?
When I was 6, I took my first real airplane ride in an aluminum high-wing monoplane called the Tin Goose. The 12 seats inside were all wicker chairs. It rattled like crazy.
This is not a good idea!
My dad was scared. I enjoyed it. I became obsessed with learning about planes, reading about them, and even building them. As a kid, I built so many model airplanes, they covered my entire bedroom and part of the basement. By the time I was 15, instead of buying toy airplanes, I started saving my money for flying lessons. I worked 3 jobs, making 40 cents an hour. It took me over 22 hours to pay for a single lesson. Let's go! Another flight!
You really like planes, don't you?
What gave you that idea? By 16, I got my real pilot's license, even before I got my driver's license. As a teenager, I loved flying so much, I'd have the same dream over and over. In the dream, by holding my breath, I could hover over the ground. I didn't fly or really move, I'd just float there. When I got older, I joined the Navy, flying in 78 missions during the Korean War. On one of them, my plane lost its wing, so I needed to eject and get out immediately.
We hope you enjoyed this preview.
To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.